Hello students, in our last class we have discussed about center of gravity and principle of moments. Today we will see the topics uniform linear motion and uniform circular motion and some of the terms related with circular motion. So what is linear motion? When a body moves in a straight line path, the body is said to be in linear motion. You will see this picture. You can see a car and a bike are moving on a straight road. If this car and bike are covering equal distance in equal interval of time, then these vehicles are said to be in the state of uniform linear motion. Suppose that a boy is moving on a straight road. Suppose I for covering every 100 meter, he takes 1 minute. First 100 meter is covered in 1 minute. The next 100 meter is also covered in 1 minute. Third 100 meter, that is also covered in 1 minute. So you can see that equal distance is covered in equal interval of time, and this boy moves in a definite direction. He moves straight. So we can say that he has a linear motion. And what about his speed? His speed is a uniform. Why the speed is uniform? Because he travels equal distance in equal interval of time. So we can say that in uniform linear motion, the speed is uniform. And what about the velocity? So here, he moves in a straight line. He has equal displacement. He has equal displacement in equal interval of time. So we can say that velocity is also uniform. And what about the acceleration? So acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. In this case, velocity is uniform. So change in velocity is zero. So, acceleration is zero. So, the main points about uniform linear motion are, in uniform linear motion, speed is uniform, velocity is uniform, and acceleration on the body is zero. Now, we will see uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion. When a body moves in a circular path, the motion is said to be circular. For example, a planet moves around the sun. Suppose this is sun and a planet is moving around the sun. So this planet moves around the sun in a circular path. So we can say that this planet has circular motion. In this picture, this is the nucleus of an atom and this is an electron which is moving around the nucleus. How it moves? It moves in a circular path. So, an electron which is moving around the nucleus has circular motion.
So, suppose this is a moon and this is Earth. This is Earth and this is Moon. Moon is revolving around the Earth in a circular path. So this is an example of circular motion. And in this case, when Moon moves around the Earth in a circular path, it covers equal distance. It covers equal distance in equal interval of time. The moon, which is moving around the earth in a circular path, covers equal distance in equal interval of time. So we can say that its speed is uniform. The speed of moon, which is moving around the earth, that is an example of body with a uniform speed. But since it changes the direction, moon moves around the earth in a circular path, changes its direction. Even though it is an example of a uniform speed, since it changes the direction, since it changes the direction, so it has a variable velocity. So this one, moon has variable velocity. Why it has a variable velocity? Because the moon changes its direction. That is why it has variable velocity. Since it is a velocity varies, so the moon has the acceleration. Okay, the same in the case of the electron which is moving around the nucleus. That has a uniform speed but variable velocity. Why it has variable velocity? Because the direction changes. So, a body which is having uniform circular motion, they have uniform speed, variable velocity, and they have acceleration. These are the main points. In order to continue this uniform circular motion, in the case of moon around the earth in circular path, electrons moving around the nucleus on its own orbits in circular path, the planets which are moving around the sun on circular orbits, these are all examples of uniform circular motion. In order to continue this circular motion, they must have some force. Due to that force only, it can continue circular motion. From where they get this force? So this force is called centripetal force. Centripetal force. Due to this centripetal force only, the body continues the circular motion. Otherwise it will stop. So what is centripetal force? When a body moves in a circular path, there is a force which is acting towards the center. Of the circular path. That is called centripetal force. When a body moves in a circular path, a force acts towards the center of the circular path. That is called a centripetal force. And from where it gets the centripetal force? In the case of a moon, which is revolving around the earth, the gravitational force of the earth, provides the centripetal force. The electrons which are moving around the nucleus, the electrostatic force of the nucleus provides the centripetal force. So means, what is electrostatic force in the case of the nucleus of an atom? In the nucleus of an atom, protons and neutrons are present. Protons have positive charge and neutrons are neutral. So nucleus has positive charge and electrons have negative charge. So there is an attraction between the opposite charge. So in this case of electron, the positive charge of the nucleus that provides the electrostatic force. That electrostatic force is the centripetal force in the case of electrons which are moving around the nucleus on its circular orbit. And the case of the planet, the case of the planets which are moving around the sun on circular orbit, the gravitational force of the sun, provides the centripetal force to the planets. So due to the centripetal force, the body continues to be in uniform circular motion. Now we will see the next topic, that is centrifugal force. When a body is moving in a circular path, there is a force acting on the body that is away from the center. For example, the force which is acting away from the center. That is called the centrifugal force. For example, the moon, which is revolving around the earth in a circular path, centripetal force is acting on the moon towards the center of the circular path. And centrifugal force is also acting on the moon, that is away from the earth. Here earth is the center. So that force is acting away from centrifugal force. Centrifugal force is acting away from the center. The direction of centrifugal force is opposite to the direction of centripetal force. Centripetal force is acting towards the center and centrifugal force is acting away from the center. So centripetal force is center seeking force and centrifugal force is an outward force. Both the centripetal force and centrifugal force are acting on the same body. In this case of a moon which is moving around the earth, the centripetal force is acting on the moon and centrifugal force is also acting on the moon. the magnitude of centripetal force and centrifugal force is same. The magnitude of centrifugal force is same as that of the centripetal force. Centrifugal force is not an example of reaction force because action and reaction are not acting on the same body. For example, when a boy is sitting on a bench, the boy exert a force on the bench. That is the action. So this action force acts on the bench and the bench exerts a force on the boy. So that is a reaction force. So that reaction force acts on the boy. So action and reaction are not acting on the same body. But in the case of centrifugal force and centripetal force, so we cannot call centrifugal force as a force of reaction of centripetal force because the centripetal force and the centrifugal force are acting on the same body. That is why centrifugal force is not called as a reaction force. Okay. Now, let us go through a numerical. A uniform meter rule can be balanced at the 70 centimeter mark when a mass of 0.05 kilogram is hung from the 94 centimeter mark. Draw a diagram of the arrangement and find the mass of the meter rule. A uniform meter rule. First of all, we have to draw a meter rule. So, you know the length of a meter rule is 100 centimeter. The length of the meter rule is 100 centimeter. And it is balanced at the 70 centimeter mark. Balanced at 70 centimeter mark. This is the fulcrum. Fulcrum is at 70 centimeter. And 0.05 kilogram is hung from the 94 centimeter. 0.05 kilogram. kilogram is hung from the 94 centimeter mark. So, we have to find the mass of the meter rule. You know, the mass of the meter rule is acting through the center of gravity. So, what is the center of gravity of the meter rule? That is 50 centimeter. So, mass of the meter rule is taken as m kilogram. So this is the diagram of the arrangement. Okay, a 100 centimeter long rule, that is a meter rule. It is balanced at 70 centimeter mark and 0.05 kilogram is hung from at the mark 94 centimeter. So in question it is asked to find the mass of the meter rule. The mass of the meter rule is concentrated at its center of gravity, that is 50 centimeter. Now we have to apply the principle of moment. That is total anti-clockwise moment is equal to total clockwise moment. Total anti-clockwise moment. Is equal to total clockwise moment. So what is the anti-clockwise moment? So you know the formula to find moment of force, that is equal to force into perpendicular distance from the turning point to the point where the force is applied. So the force is this, that is m, into what is the perpendicular distance from the turning point to the point where the force is applied, that is 70 minus 50, 20 centimeter. Then what is the total clockwise moment? Force into perpendicular distance. Force is 0.05 kilogram. And what is the perpendicular distance from the turning point to the point where the force is applied? That is 94 minus 70. 94 minus 70 is 24 centimeter. Now we have to solve and find this. That is equal to 0.05 kg into 24 centimeter divided by 20 centimeter. Centimeter cancel. Then this 24 and 20 we got in a force table. 24, 6 fours are 24 and 6 fives. 5 fours are 20. Now 0.05 and 5 we got when we get a 0.01. 6 into 0.01 is equal to 0.06 kilogram. So this is the answer. So students, today we have discussed the topics uniform linear motion and uniform circular motion. Then we have seen the definitions of centripetal force and centrifugal force. And in uniform linear motion, speed is uniform, velocity is uniform, acceleration is zero. And in uniform circular motion, speed is uniform, but the velocity is variable and there is acceleration. So these are the main points. So you have to go through your book and you have to solve some more numericals which are given in the book. In the next class, we will see with another topic.